Hi friends, welcome to OFA Studies. This is part 40 in Azure Data Factory Play Series. In this video, we are going to discuss about switch activity in Azure Data Factory, and also we are going to look at practical implementation of it with a demo. So what is switch activity in ADF? Switch activity is something very similar to the switch statement which we use inside our programming languages. Okay, so that is the reason when you use this switch activity, what will happen is it is going to evaluate the activities based upon the cases which match your condition inside the switch. Okay, so whatever the condition you use inside the switch, if that condition is going to match with any case there, then inside that particular case activity, sorry, inside the case block, if you have any activities added there, then those activities are going to run. Let me look at a practical implement of it. This is our data factory which we created from our past videos, right? So ADF demo Mahir. So let's look at a requirement now. So requirement is something like this. My pipeline should actually perform a copy activity. What it should do is it should copy a file from source location to output folders. Might be output one folder or output two folder. So this folder determination has to happen using a pipeline parameter. So whatever the parameter value it has, so into that particular folder my pipeline has to copy the file from the source location. So this is what the requirement. Let's look how to implement this requirement with switch activity. Let's go to Azure Data Factory. Let me create a new pipeline. So pipeline name is pipeline 5, let it be. Let's create a parameter first. So the parameter name is going to be, let's say, folder name. Okay, so this parameter is actually going to hold the folder name. So let's say default value is output 2 for output 1 for now. Okay, so now with this requirement, it is clear that we should have one data set for source location and another data set for destination locations, right? So what we can do, let's create a data set of parameterized type. Now we have discussed everything, what is data set and how to create a parameterized data sets, everything in our past videos, so please watch them before watching this video. Click this new data set here. Let's select the blob storage. Click on continue. Let's select this binary type because I am going to use the binary file, text files. Click on continue. Let's say this data set name is output location data set, right? Okay, so we need to get the location from the storage demo. This is the storage account, actually my blob storage account. I have already created this connection string, I mean linked service for this storage account. Okay, so now let me click on browse to browse the location. Okay, so my storage account has this ADF demo container. Let me select that. Click on OK. So container name is file. I am not going to give any folder name for now. Click OK. Okay, now what I will do, this is my data set level, right? Okay, so let me go to the parameters. So here what I want to do is I want to create a new parameter and I want to say parameter name as folder. Okay, now once I come back to connection tab, so this is the storage account I am using. This is the blob storage and file path I am using ADF container and folder name. I want a dynamic content here, so click this add dynamic content and let's use this parameter folder which we created just now. So at runtime, whatever the value you pass for this parameter, that value is going to become a folder name for your data set. Okay, so this is fine. Data set for output location. Now data set for source location, right, as per the requirement. So if you see this input data set, this data set holds the source location. This is again, if you go to connection tab, same storage demo Mahir location. This is the linked service. So I am using a data.txt file from the storage location, which is under input folder of ADF demo container. Okay, so let's think like this is the source file which we are trying to copy. Okay, now inside the same ADF demo Mahir, we want to copy folder into either output one folder or output two folders as we discussed now. So let's go to our pipeline once again. So folder name, as we know, we discussed like this parameter is going to supply the folder name. So let's use a switch activity now. Let me drag and drop this switch activity on the canvas. So this activity will contain three types of settings: general, activities, user properties. About user properties, we have already discussed in our past videos. Please watch that inside the Azure Data Factory Play Series. In part 30, we discussed that. Okay, let me go to general tab. Here you need to provide the name and description for your activity. Then go to activities tab. So here what you need to do is, the first thing is you need to provide the expression which has to be converted as a value. Then that value has to be compared with the case statement. So don't worry, I'm going to do this practical now. Let's click this add dynamic content. So what I want is this expression to be my folder name from the pipeline parameter. Okay, click finish. Right, if you see this expression of the switch activity, the evaluated case insensitive string value will be matched with the each case. So that's what it is. Whatever the value it will generate here, that value is going to compare with the case statements. Okay, let's add a new case here. So this is the case one, right? Let's click this pencil icon. Let's say case one is, I don't want this case one, this case should be output one. Okay, now in this case I want to copy data, right? So from where I want to copy data? I want to copy data from this input blob, input data set. Then I want to the sync should be the data set which we just created, right? Let's scroll down, output location data set, select that. Let me make it up. So here the folder name, right, this parameter we have to pass it. So we have to pass it this parameter value from our pipeline parameter, right? Click this add dynamic content, scroll down, select your parameter from your pipeline, click finish. Okay, so that's it. So now what will happen, let's go back to pipeline and explain you what will happen is, whenever the execution comes to switch statement, it is going to look at the expression and it is going to look at the parameter name called folder name. So what value this folder name parameter holds? So as I said, this folder name is currently holding output one, right? So then immediately this expression becomes output one. Now what it will do is, it will go inside the case statements and it will check if there is any case created with output one. You can see here output one case is available. So condition matches. So in this case, what it will do is, it is going to execute the activities whatever you written inside these particular activities. So what activities we defined here? Just now we defined, right? We defined the copy activity here to copy data from source to destination folder. That is going to be the parameter value, right? Now come back. Let's assume if I have another case, that is going to be, because as we said, there should be a case for output two also, right? Because we should be able to copy data to output one or output two based upon parameter value. So we need to have a case for output two also. So let's make this type as case as output 2. Now do the same, drag and drop the copy activity, select the source and sync locations. So source is input data set, go to sync. Inside the sync, select the data set which we created, then here select the parameter name to pass pipeline parameter, but this is folder name parameter, click on finish. Okay, that's it. So now my pipeline will work exactly the same way how I described the description requirement here. And one more thing, if you closely observe here, there is something called default which is currently having no activities, right? So what is this is, for example, this switch expression value is not going to match with any of the case values here. In that case, what it will do is, it will go directly into the default, and whatever the activities you define inside the default, those activities will run. Okay, so in my case, I don't want to do that, so I am not going to add any activities for default. Okay, so hope this given a clear idea about what is switch activity and how it will actually help you to create the case statements, and so that you can control the flow of the execution based upon the requirement. Let's go to presentation. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press bell icon to get notifications whenever I add. Thank you.